Another type's gotta have someone. Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. Today I'm going to show you how I set up a bathroom cleaning caddy for my son who is now in college. Yes, I have a son in college. It has been a ride, it is an adventure, and I'm looking forward to this next chapter in his life and my life. In the meantime, I set him up with this cleaning caddy for college because he is staying in a house with two other roommates, and I'm excited to show you how I set it up because it's pretty much how I set it up for our whole house. And he has been cleaning the bathroom, his bathroom, since he started high school, which has been 4 years. So he knows how to clean a bathroom. I have three simple steps to set up your bathroom cleaning caddy, whether it's for your college house, your guest bath, kids, or master bathroom. My first tip is to have one caddy per bathroom. Now your caddy can be something like this. This is the one I like because it has a handle. It's very sturdy. It is the brand Casabella. You can get this at Target. I've also seen it at the Container Store and of course on Amazon. I'll put any links to the products in the description box or show notes below. Of course, if you don't want a caddy like this, get any type of container, a bucket, one of the containers from the Dollar Tree, anything to put all your products and tools together so that it could stay underneath the bathroom sink. And the reason I like to have one caddy per bathroom is because all the tools and products are right there underneath the sink in the cabinet. It's easy to reach, it's accessible, and I don't have to go from one bathroom to another or to wherever the cleaning supplies are and bring it to the bathroom. It's just one less obstacle from getting the bathroom clean. My second tip is to have the right tools. So you see here, I always have a pair of gloves because, you know, you don't want to touch stuff in the bathroom, even if it's your bathroom. So have gloves ready to put on, and it actually lets you clean better because you're not afraid to touch stuff, right? And then I also have two different types of sponges. This one you can see is a little bit different from this one. Okay, you can have ones that are different colors, different textures. One is for the bathroom sink and the other is for the bathroom shower or tub. Next, I have a dish wand. I like the one with the bristles and not the sponge. And of course, I always like stuff that are clear because I can see how much product is inside here. And each dish wand usually has this thing that you push so that the soap will come out. I use this for the shower. It's the daily shower cleaner where I put half dish soap and half vinegar. It's really easy to use. You know, you just press that, and when I have the conditioner setting in my hair, I go ahead and grab this and I scrub the floors, I scrub the walls, I even scrub the shower handles, and it's done. I do that about every other day and it keeps the bathroom shower clean. And then I also like to have rags or microfiber cloths. These are chamois that I think work really well in the bathroom. You know, whatever you can get, I like to use these versus paper towels. And then if you notice here, as far as the organization, I like this caddy because it has this divider. So I like to put the tools here on the left, and I do have another container there, the one that holds sponges by the kitchen sink, just to separate it a little bit more. And then with the gloves, you can just fold it after and put it in there. Or, like I do with my other sinks, I'm not sure how my son will do it, but I like to put a binder clip here, and then I just clip it onto the inside of the cabinet and use a command hook for that. I also like to look at the products that I use to clean the bathroom as the right tools. So sometimes I've gone through products because they're cheaper and they really don't clean that well, or I've even made my own products and, you know, just wanting to have natural products and they also don't clean well. So I've gone through different stuff. I have some bathrooms where I use more natural cleaners and then others where I use All Method or Myers or Barkeepers, or here you can see Sprayway. All right, let me show you the products that I use. One of my favorites is Myers. It is a good cleaner, it's non-toxic, and I like the different smells that they have. Also, you can get it at Target. So especially since this is for my son, he can go to any Target and replenish these. My absolute favorite is the Myers Baking Soda Cream Cleaner. I use this for the bathroom sink and also the tub and shower when I'm doing doing a deep clean. And then I have the Meyers Toilet Bowl Cleaner. I like the green one, which is the lemon verbena scent. And then I always like to have some type of air freshener for the toilet room. My bathroom actually has a toilet room. There's actually a door that closes the toilet area. So here's a room freshener. I also like the J.R. Watkins brand from Target. And then another cleanser I like to use is Barkeeper's Friend. I also like the Meyers cleanser, but they were out when I was shopping for his cleaning caddy. And then someone had recommended this Sprayway glass cleaner. I absolutely love it. My husband loves it. He uses it in his Pilates studio, which has a whole bunch of mirrors, and it is perfect each time. Okay, and then lastly, we have here the multi-surface Meyers. I also like to use the Method one, the grapefruit. Okay, by the way, this is the dish soap that I'm gonna be giving to my son. It doesn't belong in the cleaning caddy because he just has to fill this up a little bit and then put it back underneath the kitchen sink. And then I'm also giving him the Method wood polish cleaner for the dining room table that we gave him. I just wanted to show you these two products, but they won't be going into the cleaning caddy. My third tip is to put the products in order. What I mean by that is I put the products in the order of how I clean, because in the bathroom, for me, there are natural zones. There is the sink and mirror area where we have our makeup, where we have our different products underneath inside the cabinets. There's also the area of the tub and shower. There's the toilet area, and then there's the floor. So for example, in our master bath, we have double sinks. So I have grouped this next to the sponges because I clean those sinks daily in the morning after I use them. My husband usually uses the bathroom before me. He gets to work sooner. And then I like to also clean the toilet. So since I clean those two areas daily, I like to group these together. And then I like to have the freshener next to the toilet bowl cleaner because that is used in the toilet area. I have this as its own zone where it's for deep cleaning the tub, the shower, and the sinks. And then for the sink area, I like to use, of course, the glass cleaner and then the multi-purpose spray for the counter. So we have the sink counters and the sink mirror, so those are together. And then lastly, for the floors, I vacuum them and then I use this multi-purpose product to wipe down the floors. I actually get down on my hands and knees, spray, and I get every corner of the floors in the bathroom. So you can see that here are all the tools and then my daily cleaners. This goes with that. This is by itself, and then these go together. So that's it, simple and straightforward. This is how I set up a bathroom cleaning caddy. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home an entertaining simple. Please leave a comment below and let me know what's in your cleaning caddy, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. If you'd like to support me on Patreon, the link's below.